Hi, everyone. It's Rev Dub of Miracles One here with you for Living the Lessons podcast. And this is Lessons 157 through 161, since I was on retreat for those days and didn't get a chance to record my posts. The posts are already written and they were posted daily while I was gone. So 157, into his presence, what I enter now. So today I will spend the day in silence so I may commune with him. This is where I find myself, and this is where my joy is increased. In the arc of the golden light, I accept and I receive. I am humbled, yet I am strong. To experience this lesson, you must experience this lesson. There are no words that could bring the intimacy with him. It is in our application of this idea that does so. And once again, these are my thoughts as I practice the lessons. So 158 was, today I learn to give as I receive. So my thoughts for this day, today I see the illuminated mind in all my brothers. It is present within my own mind, and I allow its rays to gently touch each mind as well. No more is separation perceived, but only the purity of our essence. It is my spiritual sight I use today to bless each one and bless myself. We don't often recall our innocence or holiness, but today, let us be prompted to do so. See today with the eyes of Christ and bring great benefit to the world. On to 159. 159 is, I give the miracles I have received. And so in this one's a little bit longer, there's a quote. You recognize your brother as yourself, and thus do you perceive that you are whole. As we journey this life, we do happen upon those individuals that test our patience. They seem to disappear and move on, yet that same personality appears once again. We have it, and I have it too. I know for me sometimes it creates great ire in me. For this typical personality usually revolves around deceit, dishonesty, abuse, physically, emotionally, etc. You know, abuse of kindness, of generosity, of system, etc. Facade, inconsistency, irrationality, disloyalty, and after all, this claims of victimhood, if any of these are discovered and carried out to the light of day. Yes, this is the personality I have to recall in my mind to offer the miracle, a shift from fear to love. This does not mean I have to stay in the presence of these personalities, but it does mean I have to do my own inner work on forgiveness and seeing all as the Christ. They are my Savior and will lead me home. The item here to remember is I do not have to prove my forgiveness strength, if you will, by remaining in this personality's presence. I can move on and still be silent, safe, and secure in the Holy Spirit. Boundaries still help us here in the world to offer some shelter from the storm. Jesus wants us to feel safe and to heal at our own pace. We do not have to suffer crucifixion by others. That was the last useless journey, if you recall. And isn't this personality either reminding us of ourselves or of fears we do not want to recall? Mine goes back in time. It creates triggers for me of PTSD here in the world, yet it doesn't have to be as so. I can remember the light and the warmth and the kindly care Christ's charity provides, as Jesus tells us. We can love ourselves enough to welcome healing into our mind. We are on the path, and so are all our brothers. We are not perfect, and neither are they. We are all here trying to find our way home. If we remember just this, we can open our mind to true forgiveness. In the light of forgiveness, miracles occur, and we can bless others with the same. Will circumstances change, and you be once again in the personality's presence? It could, or it could not. No one is to say what individualized curriculum leads your journey. Only the Holy Spirit has that say. So be open, be willing, and you will accept each miracle into your heart. And so now on to 160, which is, I am at home, fear is the stranger here. At one time or another, we all feel we do not belong. It could be in a group, a family, a workplace, an organization, or a gathering. What we are feeling is this lesson. We feel as strangers in a strange land. Certainly, I have felt out of place many times in my life. It's that feeling, though, that has led me and you to A Course in Miracles. We see the world differently, you and I, and that's why we feel the way we do. The rest of the world is just seemingly blissfully unaware. So this reminds me of the movie The Matrix. There are those who see the world differently and come to find Morpheus, who then offers us the opportunity to see the truth. The truth is, A Course in Miracles coming into our lives, and that is the proverbial red pill, as we witnessed in the movie. The truth may seem hard to swallow, but it is the truth. This world is an illusion, and we have every reason to feel out of place because it is not our real home. Our eyes are now open. We know the truth. We feel the truth, yet at times we wish to still be unaware. We push the knowledge aside as to never know what God created. But it pops up. We glimpse it, and finally we desire more glimpses. We desire peace instead of what we experience. And this is when we make the choice to listen to the voice for God assure us that what God created is eternal, free, and forever joined with Him. So finally, lesson 161, which is, give me your blessing, Holy Son of God. So I used to joke with this lesson, similar to how George's dad in the Seinfeld episode proclaimed loudly, serenity now, when he was learning to be more peaceful. It would be for me, give me your blessing, you Holy Son of God. Of course, wanting to say something else instead of God. You know, we laugh because we relate, right? Underneath, we acknowledge it is to our advantage to offer the blessing to all our brothers here because we are only offering it to ourselves in truth. So when I observe someone else and make judgments, it's my own judgments, criticisms, or whatever is at hand. I've said it before, we can still have our personal boundaries here in the world. We only attack because of the deep-seated fear within us. Why are we afraid? And afraid of what? We are terrified of the truth. We shake in God's presence because we believe we have usurped His power. This is what the ego slyly whispers in our ear so that we may rise up against our enemy, God, and all associated with Him. Here now we are offered a tremendous gift in the practice of today's idea. We see our brother, you know the one, in all his or her ways. We willingly peek behind the curtain that repels us to see that this one is the one who will free our mind from the self-imposed chains. So give me your blessing, Holy Son of God. I would behold you with the eyes of Christ and see my perfect sinlessness in you. In using this in my meditation time, surely I had those to offer this gift of blessing. I found even myself in need of this blessing, as at times, as we all do, we refuse to see our own goodness. We transform together in the shining light of love. So those are my thoughts on the last few lessons while I was on retreat. And so be sure to go to our lesson website, which is acimlessons.org, and our main website, miracles1.org, for tons of resources for you as a course student. So thanks so much for joining with me today. And as always, I wish you much peace. Namaste.